Hello everyone, we are going to talk about replication and movement of plant viruses today. We know that plant viruses are obligate parasites. They depend on the host for replication, for movement, and all the protein synthesis functions that are required for plant viruses are carried out by host protein synthesizing machinery. Viruses are totally dependent on the host for all their functions. So, replication also is one of the main functions that a plant virus undertakes in the host. And the dependence of the virus on the host is on the following thing. The viral components like amino acids and nucleotides, which are required to synthesize protein and nucleic acids respectively. So all these amino acids and the nucleotides are supplied by the host. The energy for polymerization, all the amino acids are polymerized to make protein or polypeptide chain. Nucleotides are polymerized to form the nucleic acid molecule. The energy comes from the host. Then the proteins which are synthesized, we know that a virus can have 4 to 10 number of proteins, and essentially a virus has 3 number of genes, and so 3 genes code for 3 different proteins. Now the proteins are synthesized using the protein synthesizing machinery or ribosome of the host. Then the host enzymes for post-translational modification of proteins. So for all these, the viruses depend on the host. And the genome of the virus, we have now the idea of how the plant virus genomes are. Most of the plant viruses, about 90% of the plant viruses have single-stranded RNA as the genome. It may be positive sense or negative sense. Then double-stranded RNA is also there as plant virus genome. Single-stranded DNA, double-stranded DNA also there. Now in this presentation, we will focus on the replication of single-stranded RNA plant viruses, because most viruses have single-stranded RNA. Then we will also briefly discuss the replication strategies of double-stranded RNA virus, single-stranded DNA virus, and double-stranded DNA viruses. We have some general events in the plant virus replication. We are more or less familiar with the replication steps of viruses, but when it comes to plant virus, we have some general events, but these events may differ depending on the viral genome or depending on the type of viruses. So the first event is entry into the host. This entry of virus into the host cell, it can happen mechanically or by some vectors. Then after entry in the host, the second thing is uncoating or disassembly. And this disassembly, that means the coat protein molecules and the nucleic acid molecule, they get separated. So uncoating occurs, the coat protein molecules get separated, and the nucleic acid molecule comes out and the genome comes out. And sometimes uncoating is immediately followed by translation. So the moment uncoating starts, the moment the viral genome comes out, the translation starts. Translation starts because the viral genome is single-stranded RNA plus sense. It acts as mRNA. So mRNA can be translated readily, we know already. So this uncoating and translation can occur simultaneously, and this disassembly or uncoating is known as co-translational disassembly. After this, we have production of mRNA. We have production of proteins, synthesis of functional proteins, then replication of genome. Genome is replicated. Then coating occurs, or assembly occurs. because the code protein has been synthesized, the genome has been replicated. So now assembly occurs or coating occurs. After that, we have an event of movement. The virus particles move from one cell to another or from one part of the plant to another. And finally, from one plant to another plant, that is spread of the virus. So replication of plus sense single-strand RNA, we have a scheme, and that scheme is like this. The plus sense single-stranded RNA, it makes the negative sense single-strand RNA, and this negative sense single-strand RNA acts as template. And this single-stranded negative sense RNA acting as template forms more number of plus sense single-stranded RNA, that is the genome type single-stranded RNA. These plus sense single-stranded RNAs replicated once, then get coated by the coat protein molecule, and then full virion molecule is formed. Full virion particle is formed. So let us see this here in this diagram. Say in the plant cell, in the first step, we get two virus particles introduced inside the plant cell. Then the coat protein molecules get separated. CP means coat protein. They get separated and the nucleic acid molecule comes out. So nucleic acid molecule is here. The genome is here. 5 prime end and 3 prime end. Then immediately we get translation. So this is the ribosome unit, which is of host origin. And this ribosome makes translation of the viral genome, which is acting as mRNA. After translation, we get some protein synthesized. RP, replication protein, is synthesized. So once the replication protein is synthesized, the genome, viral genome, is replicated. So it is the first viral protein which is synthesized from the viral genome. After translation, we get replication protein. This replication protein then makes the genome, 5 prime to 3 prime end, this genome replicated. So replication occurs via formation of a negative strand. So when the replication occurs, this is RNA dependent RNA polymerase. So when this 5 prime to 3 prime genomic RNA is used as template, then we get negative sense. Since the genome is plus sense, we get complementary negative sense. So these negative sense RNA molecules are formed and they are templates for synthesis of genomic RNA. So these negative sense RNA molecules give rise to more number of plus sense RNA molecules. So these plus sense RNA molecules are the genomes. Then from these negative sense RNA molecules, we also get plus sense RNA molecules which act as subgenomic RNA, because we have to get coat protein and movement protein synthesized. As we know, in case of TMV, the coat protein and movement protein genes are coded from the subgenomic RNAs. So from the subgenomic RNAs, we get movement proteins synthesized and coat proteins synthesized. Initially, we saw that the genome is replicated. Many plus strand molecules are formed. Plus strand single strand RNAs are formed. Now these plus strand single strand RNAs, they are coated by these coat proteins, and we get mature virus particles synthesized. Now in case of tobacco mosaic virus, the RNA molecules which are replicated, plus strand single stranded RNA molecules, they can move to next cell with the help of the movement proteins. So the tobacco mosaic virus can move to next cell and to next cell again as the RNA molecule with the help of movement proteins. So this is how replication occurs. The virus entry, then uncoating, then translation, formation of replication protein. This replication protein makes negative sense template. From the negative sense template, we get replication protein working further, and then we get plus strand single strand RNAs replicated, plus strand single strand RNAs, which are then coated by the coat protein synthesized from the subgenomic RNAs, and we get full mature virus particles. These virus particles can now be used for transmission by mechanical means, but the viruses can also move to nearby cells as RNA molecule with the help of the movement proteins. Okay, so this is how replication of single-stranded RNA viruses occur, and this is exemplified by tobacco mosaic virus here in this slide. Now, for negative sense single-stranded RNA viruses like plant rhabdoviruses, how the replication occurs? The plant rhabdoviruses can be grouped into two categories: cytorhabdovirus, which replicate in the cytoplasm of the host, and nucleorhabdovirus, which replicates in the host nucleus. So in this case, the scheme of replication is negative sense single-strand RNA, which is the genomic RNA. From there, plus sense single-strand RNAs are formed. Now, these plus sense single-strand RNAs are templates on the basis of which more number of minus sense single-strand RNAs are formed, which are genomic RNAs. And these viruses, minus sense single-strand RNA viruses or plant rhabdoviruses, they also replicate in the insect vectors. We know that many viruses replicate in the insect vector, which are replicative type, which are persistent type. Then replication of double-stranded RNA viruses. Double-stranded RNA viruses are present in the family Rioviridae, and in this family there are many viruses which have 10 to 12 number of double-stranded RNA genome segments. So these are multipartite viruses, and the scheme of replication is double-stranded RNA virus. There are many particles. From there, plus sense single-stranded RNAs are formed, which act as template, and from there again double-stranded RNAs are formed. Okay. Now replication can occur in the cytoplasm. Replication also occurs in the insect vectors. So these viruses replicate both in the plant and the vectors. Replication of single-stranded DNA viruses. Single-stranded DNAs are the genomes in case of Geminiviridae, and the replication scheme is single-stranded DNA, which is the genome. From there, double-stranded DNA is formed. From double-stranded DNA, again, single-stranded DNAs are formed as the genomic DNA molecule. Geminiviruses have rolling circle mechanism of replication like viroids. Viroids have rolling circle mechanism. Virusoids also have rolling circle mechanism of replication. So single-stranded DNAs have this rolling circle mechanism. And this is a two-step process. In the first phase, the single-strand genomic DNA is the template for the synthesis of minus strand. So when this plus strand and minus strand they occur together, they actually form a double strand, and this double strand DNA is the replicative form. This replicative form acts as the template for both transcription and plus strand synthesis, generating free single stranded DNA. Replication of double stranded DNA viruses. Double stranded DNA viruses are the members of Colymoviridae, and the replication scheme is double-stranded DNA. From there, RNA is formed, and from RNA again DNA is formed. So here RNA to DNA formation is known as reverse transcription. So here reverse transcriptase enzyme is required, and this replication has two phases. One is nuclear phase, where viral DNA is transcribed by host DNA dependent RNA polymerase, and in the cytoplasmic phase, the RNA product of transcription is reverse transcribed by virus encoded RNA dependent DNA polymerase or reverse transcriptase. So here we see that the double stranded DNA virus Colmevirid, this is the genome, and we have uncoating followed by movement of the DNA genome into nucleus of the host cell. Inside the nucleus, the single stranded gaps are sealed, and then we get histone protein associating with the viral genome, and we see that the viral genome acts as mini chromosome. And this mini chromosome, viral genome, it undergoes transcription. We get RNA molecules formed, mRNAs formed. These mRNAs come out and undergo translation and form many proteins. And these proteins take part in assembly, in the formation of virus particle again. Now these RNA molecules also undergo reverse transcription and form DNA, single-stranded, then double-stranded DNA, and this double-stranded DNA is coated and we get mature virus particle formed again. Now replication error, this is something that one must know. Nucleic acids that replicate DNA to DNA have much lower mutation rate, much lower replication error than those that replicate by other pathways. This is because DNA dependent DNA polymerase, so DNA to DNA formation, has a proof reading ability that checks that the correct nucleotide has been added, whereas the other polymerase, DNA dependent RNA polymerase, for example RDRP, RNA dependent RNA polymerase, and reverse transcriptase. So when RNA to DNA is formed or RNA to RNA is formed, this process of formation has some enzymes involved in them, and those enzymes responsible for RNA to DNA formation or RNA to RNA formation, they do not have proof reading ability. So there is more replication error. That means RNA viruses replicate with more errors, more mutation rates, whereas DNA viruses replicate, especially DNA to DNA, when replication occurs DNA to DNA, then they have less replication error. So wherever RNA polymerase enzyme, RNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme, or RNA dependent DNA polymerase enzymes are involved, we get more of replication errors or more mutations. Now how the movement occurs for plant viruses? Within a host plant, the viruses move from one cell to another, or from one plant part to another. Viruses also move from plant to plant. There are ways through which viruses have evolved, and they move through vectors from one plant to another. The cell-to-cell movement occurs through plasmodesmata. Plasmodesmata are the cell-to-cell connections, and these channels or bridges or connections are too small to allow passage of whole virus particle from one cell to another. And viruses usually move from one cell to another as whole particle or just as nucleic acid protein complex. As we have seen in case of tobacco mosaic virus, the RNA molecules can move from one cell to another with the help of the movement proteins. Whole particle is not required for movement from one cell to another. So here movement proteins have role to play for movement of virus from one cell to another. These movement proteins are not only required for cell-to-cell movement but for host range determination. Movement proteins cause expansion of plasmodesmata, so that plasmodesmata size gets bigger and the nucleic acid protein complex of the virus can move easily. These movement proteins are basically the homologs of host proteins that naturally traffic mRNAs between cells. Host cells have natural flow of substances from one cell to another through plasmodesmata. And the proteins that a host has to traffic many mRNA molecules from one cell to another naturally, these proteins and the virus-coded proteins, movement proteins, are homologous. These movement proteins also act as suppressors of gene silencing. So, wherever a host defense is activated, wherever a host tries to defend the attack of a plant virus, the movement proteins of the virus act as suppressor of that host defense. So, one of the mechanisms of defending plant viruses is gene silencing. Movement proteins of the virus, they act as suppressors of gene silencing. So, the movement proteins help the virus to overcome the host defense and become successful as pathogen. For cell-to-cell movement of viruses, coat proteins are usually not required. But for movement of virus from one plant part to another plant part, which is actually the long distance movement within a plant, it occurs through phloem. And this long distance movement through phloem occurs as whole particle or protein nucleic acid complex. In this, coat protein is required. Then, plant-to-plant movement. Plant-to-plant movement occurs as whole particles. And we know this can happen mechanically for tobacco mosaic virus or through vectors. There are many viruses which have vectors, leafhopper, planthopper, white flies. Vectors can transmit the virus from one plant to another, but whole plant virus particle is required to be transmitted for plant-to-plant movement. Here in this picture, you can see how the Protozoovirus X uses viral proteins to alter plasmodesmata and allow the whole virus particles to move from one cell to another. In the right-hand side, we can see that how cowpea mosaic virus uses protein tubule to line plasmodesmata and allow whole virus particles to move between cells. So, here in this lecture, we discussed the replication and movement of viruses. If you have any query related to this video, please write to me in my comment box. Thank you very much.